Hello, my wonderful and beautiful children of God. Welcome to God's beloved ASMR. I am so happy to have you here. By the way, how are you doing? close friends, which I know that we are more than that, because in the eyes of God, we are sisters and brothers. So, today I will want to share my insights to you. Are doing like Christian ASM artists to have Bible readings and such, but I don't feel led to do it today. Though I'm not saying that it's wrong, but we are just trying to be kind of sensitive to what Spirit of the Lord wants us to do, because I believe that is the most important thing. What will you profit from it if what I'm saying right now is not of the Lord's? So today I want to share to you guys, why will you want to go or to have Christian ASM artists with you? I have known a lot of Christian ASM artists, and one of my favorites are Faith-Rise ASMR and Spirit-Filled.com. You should go and check their channels, guys. I was saying, I am tackling this because one time I just want to share to you guys my experience, as a new ASM artist and as a new bee in YouTube. You want to promote your channel, because for me, I started this channel because I have a big expectation that God will do something and God will give people healing breakthroughs just through listening to me. And of course, I also want this channel to be let's say get monetized, because I really have the hour to help the church, or to be able to give in the church. So that is my reason, and I know that God knows about it. And one time I have been searching for Christian YouTubers, which I know are very many, and I happen to comment in one of her videos. I really forgot who specifically, because I do like commenting in other Christian YouTubers as well, so I might forgotten who is the person. So I said there that, oh wow, this video is a blessing, and that the YouTuber or the person should continue to do such videos because it's a faith related videos. And I also said there in my ending note that I'm also doing faith face ASMR, so I was kind of promoting my page. And then I think hours or a day later, there is this one fellow who commented and said that there is no such thing as a Christian ASMR and Christian yoga and other things like that, and she's saying that it is demonic and I should ask God for his guidance if it's from him or not. And today I also want to go to scriptures to back it up in the Word of God. So we can see today if it, Christian ASMR is really demonic or no, or not at all. So I will be reading in 1 John. Actually, this is my everyday Bible study, and like this is what I have been reading by the grace of God. And I will read from 1 John chapter 4 verses 1 to 6. Okay, verse 1. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. Verse 2. Hereby know ye the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God. Verse 3. And every spirit that confesses not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is the spirit of Antichrist, wherefore ye have heard the spirit of wherefore ye have heard, and it should come, and even now already it is in the world. Verse 4. Ye are of God, little children, and have not overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he who is in this world. Verse 5. They are of the world, therefore they speak of the world, and the world heareth them. Verse 6. The last verse. We are of God. He that knoweth God heareth you, and he that knoweth not God not heareth us. Hereby we know the spirit of truth and the spirit of error. Amen. Thank God for the reading of his word. So, as it is written in the Bible in 1 John chapter 4, that there will be a lot of false prophets that will arise. But how do we know if this person is like a real or from God? If the person is confessing Jesus, who cometh in the flesh, that in that way we can say that this person is of God. But how can we say that it's not if this person said that Jesus, just the opposite, that Jesus has not come into the flesh? And there is some parts of the Bible where the Bible said that Jesus said that he who is for us is not against us. So sometimes we have been like, there have been a lot of instances where people use the name of the Lord for in vain or for their own glory. So we are very cautious, or we are very careful whom we let in. I remember once in Apostle Paul's letter to the church that he said he is very happy whether the person is speaking good about Christ or speaking bad about him. As long as Christ is preached, it is like he is feeling fulfilled already. And sometimes we might see like the error in someone so much that we forgot, or we have forgotten, why are we really listening to this person? Isn't it because even that person, even like from all of the sides, you will judge that this person like doesn't have like a life that will, that is pleasing to God or something like that. As long as the or maybe let's just take this aside, like the person is just preaching to you, you don't know him or her anywhere or anywhere else, right? And so you have to think about whether this person is from God or not. But you know what, my beloved, the thing that is in the Bible, which is written in the Word of God in him. So that is just like the thing that we might like, we should look up to. And whoever who testifies that Jesus is the Son of God and that he has become flesh, died for our sins, and in the third day he rose again, and he has come to the Father, and he will come back to us, people who has believed in him, who believe in him. So like I am saying this because not because like I know every one of you, especially you who is listening, you have a very good heart, and I believe that you believe in Christian ASM art or ASM artists. But a student of God, if like we heard something like that, we should also have to speak out for those people, because I believe those people as they are to like share the word of God. But if some people are keeps on distracting them by saying bad things, it will just like lessen the possibility for them to like to work for more and to strive for more. And I believe that one thing that the reason why I am also doing Christian ASMR is because sometimes me myself, I am a fan, or like I really like a Christian, I mean ASMR. So before I met Christian ASMR, this though I am a Christian, I am like I really love or like watching YouTube videos about ASMR, and it really relaxes me well, and I really love that. But I just want to let everyone know that the person that you have been listening to before you sleep is very, very important. I am not judging anyone, and I don't want them to judge me as well, because only God is the judge. But I am saying that some people are there, they have a lot of backgrounds, so before you listen to them, know and ask God for discernment. Is this a person that can help me? Because let me speak some spiritual things. Like, there is what we call the transferring spirit. Like now, I remember Jesus said in John that these words have I spoken unto you, and these words are life. It means that when Jesus has spoken or is speaking or have spoken, it means that there is transferring of life from Jesus to the person who is listening to him. So that is what is happening now. As you are listening to me, you are getting something from me. There is a transfer of spirit, or there is like an impartation in which that you are getting something from me through the Spirit of God. So that is that's why I am saying that it's very, very important that you will be very choosy of the people that you will hear before you sleep. Because when we are asleep, our body is at rest, and we become very vulnerable. So if you have the word of God in your ears, it goes to your brain, it goes to your heart, and it strengthens you, as Jesus said. this channel, but you know, sometimes life happens and there are a lot of responsibilities that is on me now, but I really like doing this kind of videos because I believe that it really helps. And to my subscribers, thank you so much. I love you and may God bless you beyond understanding. I pray that you will soar high like an eagle and you will never run dry, but you will overflow in all the areas of your lives. I pray that the things that you have been praying for and the things that has been like making you burden for so long, may God remove it from you. I pray that God will open your eyes, the eyes of your understanding, to understand more of Him. I pray that God will grant you your heart desires, and I pray that may you always find the reason to thank the Lord, because He is good, and as it is written in 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 18, if I'm not mistaken, that is His will in Christ Jesus, that in everything we will give thanks to Him. Thank you so much, my beloved, and please share this to others as well. Thank you so much. I love you and may God bless you. I pray that as you sleep tonight or wherever you are safe in your family. And please, last thing I want to say is that please pray for the churches all over the world, because there has been a lot and persecution is like getting harder and harder. Please pray for other people as well, and for those what Jesus calls the lost sheep of Israel. Let's pray that we may find them and may we like help them. Thank you so much. I pray that you spread the love. I just really like have a time today to do this, but I hope God willing that these following days I will be consistent in my